And I was about to place to chair the session about the deliberation of a person whom we all admire, Dr. Subrata Maitra. In fact, my designation today, he is chairman, multidisciplinary expert group for health reforms on the Bengal. Before I tell you about a short biodata, I can tell you one thing that I have been working with him since last couple of years, more than couple of years in fact. And he has in one way reduced my workload at least to great extent by giving a tremendous favor and developing the infrastructure of health. And you all know that how rapidly the health scenario of West Bengal has expanded, has developed in a newer way, newer form. Calling about his brief biodata, I can tell you, after returning to India from UK, he worked as a physician and a critical care specialist in Woodland Hospital, Kolkata from 1990 to 1995. He was promoted to ICU in charge in the same hospital from 1995 to 2006. Has been working as senior physician and critical care specialist performing an independent full-time physician and providing service to well-being clinics, people in the hospitals, they are on the medical nursing home independently, providing critical care service on all sections of the population. He was also the chairman of Indian Society. Chairman of Indian Society of Critical Care Medicine, Kolkata. He is the author of the book Experience with Evidence in Clinical Practice. He is a member of West Bengal Medical Council and the chairman, as I have told you, of the multidisciplinary expert group. He is also the founder president of Maa Sharada Shastra Seva Parishad, which I had the privilege to visit his organization for a couple of times. And the president of Ramanandu Ramin Shastushna Kendra. These two are voluntary organizations which are dedicated towards the provision of health service to the rural population of Sundarban area. This is actually nothing about Dr. Maitra, what I have told you. He has now become a legendary figure in the field of medicine and critical care. Now he will be talking on the issue about the public health of Kolkata where we stand today. And now, without wasting any time, I will humbly request Dr. Maitra kindly deliver his address.
Thank you very much. Chairperson, dear my colleagues, senior colleagues, thanks very much for all those kind words which I do not deserve. Speaking from a Kolkata podium on public health is always a great honor to me, because I am a proud Calcuttian. I like Calcutta, I love Calcutta. So my talk will be slightly emotional, may not be statistically supported, it will be emotional. We talk about preventive medicine today, public health. But do we know that when public health started in Kolkata? And who started it? Probably you are aware of the name of Margaret West. Margaret Elizabeth Hardaway. Jake amra nibedita ma boli jake amra jani. At the age of 18 only, when she was at the age of 18, inspired by the smiling, caring call of Swami Vivekananda, he left Ireland and he came to Kolkata. Not as a nun, not as a missionary, but with one purpose, to serve as human being. And that was his motion. And you know what it is? That was 1809. And that was at the time, in the books you have already read, that was the time Calcutta was worstly affected by the plague. thousands of people were dying from plague. People were leaving their house out of fear. The only medical college at that time started was Archigar Medical College. Swami Vivekananda immediately formed a team and gave their charge to Sister Nivedita. He said, Sister, it is your charge. You are 18 years old, you do not know the language of this country. It is your charge, you form a team and show how you can serve people and can make people out of this place. And that was Sister Nivedita. So this is the history of Kolkata's party again. How many of us know about this? How many of us here who are sitting there who know about this history? He did that. Second history. The second name, you are well aware of. Everybody, all the world knows about it. Sir Roland Ross. I think you are Roland Ross. Who doesn't know Roland Ross? Everybody knows Canadian. Everybody knows that he was in Kolkata. But do we know the sad story of Sir Roland Ross? The time, kind of work, the kind of heart he had to undergo. He was from basically Mussoorie. His father was a soldier. His main work was not in Kolkata, his main work was in South India. And his main work he was from South India. And during that time, when he was coming to success, he was transferred to Rajasthan. And Rajasthan at that time was a time where malaria was not a common problem there. But he was punished there. And finally, with the help of Dr. Manson, you know Dr. Manson, one of the greatest physicians of the world. With the help of Dr. Manson, is any problem? Anybody asking me any questions? So he was transferred to Kolkata, and that was only for 8 months. Do you know that he stayed in Kolkata for only 8 months? And you know what was he was given to work for? He was not given a single worker to work with him. He appointed from his own pocket to assist him. What still was Fox Bazaar. And with the help of Fox Bazaar, he did enormous work. And he did his enormous magical work. We know all this history. By that time, accounts came from all over the world. British medical journals started writing about it. Surgical Journal of Catholic England was writing about it. By 2002, he got the Nobel Prize. By that though, he was well known. But did we know that within 1 month of time of this discovery, he was immediately transferred to Assam? Can you believe this? Can you meet it in any administration? Within 1 month, he was transferred to Assam. And the reason of transfer was to work on typhoid of that region. This is the history of public health of Kolkata. Anyway, he left the job and he went to Liverpool. And since then, what he did for the vector control, for the control of vector, mainly for malaria throughout the world, that is the history. I need not go about it. You know much better about it because you are all the students who have a problem. So I thought, if I do not use these two historical facts in Calcutta podium about the role of Calcutta in control of malaria as well as in plague control, you don't really know nothing. I have a book about Sister Nivedita, which is something interesting to the ticket and in it later on. Now today's discussion is slightly different. Today I am going to talk about the wet land of Kolkata. This term may be a bit unfamiliar to a lot of people. What is wetland? What does it mean? Wetland means theoretically is a marshy land. Small sandy ponds, but the depth of water is not more than 4 feet. There is a lot of flora and fauna species, lots of agricultural products are there, but they sustain existing. Because of the environmental pollution, environment, they sustain the city. This is Kolkata wetland. And again, we are lucky, the Kolkatans, we are lucky, we have a wetland in Kolkata. And it, naturally, we didn't make this wetland. Wetland didn't come out of it. It was out of a system because of a system started by British only. Because they started the sewage system at that time. The sewage canal was flowing from the part of the eastern part of the Kolkata. And that sewage system, which used to carry more than 22 billion of water every year, that fed that wetland system. That helped the sewage system, the solid wastelands system, the fishing culture, and the fish ponding. So that was the history of Kolkata's wetland. And today I can see this wetland, which is very important. Why it is important? I will show you my slide. It is slowly withered away because of our greed. Now today we should wear we should all swear that to save Kolkata, there is no other option than to save the poor. This is Kolkata skyline. It is not an infrastructure. Urban development. You cannot stop it. It is pure everywhere. It will happen in Brazil. It will happen in South Africa. It will happen in Singapore. It will happen. How can you stop it? Urbanization is needed, definitely. But are we doing it in a planned way? Are the sewage systems are right? Are the parking car spaces are right? Are the amount of pollution emitting from that area, it is right? Are we doing that? Are we doing the calculation? We are not doing it. I tell you, today I got stuck in South City Mall in that area. That few big buildings, traffic was absolutely stopped because the road was not prepared for the infrastructure. It is not there. We have made it because of our greedy, because of our money. We have done that one. Yes, I may have got a flare of my 80 crore rupees. But have we made that infrastructure right so that we can use it? We have not done it. And many things are coming out in Kolkata. I give another example. Sushantula goes in the airport through, it almost, from Rajaghat and Salt Lake. They are going to the airport. I tell you, I predict you today, in next 2 years' time, it will take 7 years' time to reach from that area to the airport. Because the road is not built that way. That road is 8 road. Take all the traffic of Kolkata's traffic to the airport, it's not there. Shastobabu, how old is it? 20-year city, and it has the worst possible traffic here. So what we are doing, what we are doing is the base. We are not using our plans. We are just doing it. So what I want to say that we have to watch our environment, keep our cities clean, leave our next generation alive. As you can see, this is a forest, it's called Epping Forest. Those of my colleagues, those who have worked in the UK, particularly eastern the UK, they are aware of this very Epping Forest. 11 square kilometer forest. And you know where it is? Almost in Sambaja. See, for example, 11 square kilometer of forest in Sambaja area, they are maintaining, and in last 300 years, not a single brick would have laid over there. No British rule could change that one. Why did that? Because that is their breeding space. That is their lungs. They have no environment to save them. They do that. How are we doing that? They do that. We are merely stepping for us. But fortunately, as I said, we have a wetland. Well, very, like I've shown here, this wetland, very. This is the kind of wetland of Kolkata. Thousands of villages are there, 1,200 square kilometer areas. And this is a sky view of the wetlands, how they do look like. So as I mentioned, that why wetland is needed? Because of number one, biodiversity. There's lots of falls and corners. Fishery is a big thing. Swelling is a big problem as well. Ecotourism is also a big problem. Fishery is a very big kind of thing. Because with that storage water, you can use the highest amount of fishing culture in those regions. And how did it come? It just came by the way by British, maybe their faulty way or whatever it is, their storage system, they utilize it. Now, we should not only depend on that, we should improve upon that. We have to improve our wetland, we have to improve our wetland to keep our climate from growing. Again, a new term will come across, Ramsar Wetlands Construction. Now, who is Mr. Ramsar? He is the person who first developed the concept of wetland. He showed that if this wetland, the way it is really again, on an average 10% every year, this wetland is going away. If it goes on like that, in the next 50 years' time, flies will come, drought will come. So, if we have to maintain our wetland wherever in the world, and fortunately, in that convention, there was an international convention, in that wetland convention, Kolkata, our wetland has been included in that major Ramsar's wetland convention. Now let us see some of what are the activities that we find in those areas. You can see water bodies, the bellies you can see, fishing culture you can see, the all over Kolkata, the solid waste, to where it is going. And his research took us to this discovery of East Kolkata Wastelands. The East Kolkata Wastelands holds the largest fresh fish aquaculture in the world. Remember, the largest aquaristic fishing culture of the world is in this very East Kolkata Wastelands. And the water comes from the sewage system of Kolkata. Apart from flora and fauna, the land is fertile. You grow a lot of things. Little large, red trees, pumpkin, sunflowers, eggplant. It's a fertile land. And now system is getting better, watering is getting better, pumping is better. So we can use with this wetland not only for fishing and for biodiversity and maintain the ecological balance, but for our financial purposes. Lot of people, they depend on this kind of thing. Again, it's a reputation, the importance of wetland. Here the lungs of Kolkata and Kigdi, we do not have any fresh air. Now today I am giving a talk here, this is known as Salt Lake. Just 1 year span it was in wetland. Now it is not in wetland. It is in Kolkata city and there the flyover is going. And that is a dividing line. On the east of that there is a line, that is the wetland. You go and you will have the oxygen, see what is the oxygen percentage in there. And you go outside and see what is the oxygen percentage. You can see possible difference. So in a city, within 1 kilometer span you can see what is the difference between the wetland and the normal land. And this is how the activities that we see in the wetlands, like early morning fishing, looks very nice. Migratory birds come over there, lots of flora and fauna. The agricultural land are quite rich here, to do agriculture over there. And this is Kolkata. So, I will need it, we all will need it. We all will need this house. This urbanization has to come, it has to come. But why can we do it in a more planned way? More planned way, maintaining our wetland. If we can do that, then our city will survive. Each and every international city, they do that. They maintain their environment first. That is the first priority. They maintain their environment and to go for urbanization. Are we ready for it? As I say, from Rajadhar airport will take another 2 years and it will take 6 hours to go there. Because we have not planned it. We have not planned it. To go to Shastra Bhavan from your place will take another 1 hour because of the traffic here. So the planning is important and maintenance of waterlands is important. Not that the people in Kolkata were not thinking about it. Here they thought about that. And in 2006 there was judgment by Bhagavati Mukhadev. They realized that unless we maintain this wetland, Kolkata will one day wither away. And the law was passed that land should have to be taken in a different way. This land cannot be equated with other land. You just cannot change the character of the land like that. That was in 2006. How proficient was it? And in that there was a big team. There were fishery people, there were environmental people, there were people from different administrations, district magistrates. You see that how better we can utilize the wetland. Yes, to preserve not only our environment, but also our fishery and the reputation generating from it. This is the canal system of Kolkata, just good route. All the Kolkata canals, all castles from all the Kolkata, they just flow by Basanti Highway. This is the canal I've tried to give it. Here, all these canals from all the water, sewage water, and they finally go to Pitadu. This is Pitadu River. But there's finally, there is dam. And finally what happened? The final is the same. From there is another 170 kilometers we have our big sea that is engulfed. So all these things is finally going to that place to the sea. And we see what is happening to the sea. Sundarbans is eroding. The mangrove is eroding. There people are losing their habitat. The animals are losing their habitat. So we have to do about something about it. Again, limitation. We must look for better pumping station to get water for irrigation. Canals should be monitored better so the canals flow better. The depth should be monitored regularly. Newer technology are coming for sewerage system, for solid disposal. In Thapa and Warkan, Thapa was the place where we used to do the solid disposal. It is still there. But scientific improvements are coming. And we should utilize all kinds of input from all everywhere, every quarter to improve it so that it can be maintained. same, bed is same wetland. Don't destroy it. Why? You can make a 50-story building there. Please don't destroy that waterway. That is a criminal offense. That is a criminal offense. And that has to be everybody must know. That water quality preserve, water quality preserve. If we have to sustain ourselves, if we have to sustain our next generation, this water quality must be preserved, must be preserved and not be preserved. So that's a wetland. It also looks very nice. Those who are IDC workers, they walk in at Solid 5 and 6, like our boss. Some of the offices are around the wetland. It looks nice. But maintain up to that level. Don't make sure, don't overjump it. Don't make sure that it destroys waterland. It's very nice. This is Kolkata, Salt Lake again. We are utilizing our waterland. We can use it for tourism as well. And lots of parts we can use. Very dark talked about the valleys, thousands of valleys which are connected with canals which carry the waters, the fishery water, from where the sewage water goes there and the fishery takes place. These are the valleys, fulls of valleys, hundreds of valleys were there. It's still there, they have to be maintained. Not at the cost of the valley. If you take the valleys off, maybe to take care of life by lowly people, fine, but one day we have to pay the price for that one. There's a very nice. Products of berries like fish, frogs, they're there, and livelihoods are coming out of it. Now come to pollution, this is another problem. It's everywhere, not in Kolkata, everywhere, all over the world it is there. And the result of pollution is because of constructions. Our second Howrah bridge, our flyover is going on, it's producing huge amount of pollution. But I must tell, I was just talking to Mr. Hakim, my friend, I said that you have to give us a promise that there should be a time limit, there should be a time limit. And he said it by 2003, another 5 months time, he is going to complete the first part of that kind of thing. So congratulate him that if that is done, pollution automatically comes down. Solid weight disposal, I have talked about it. This is Kolkata flyover, it divides. We are on this side. Proper Calcutta, we are Calcutta. No, we are not very people. The other side of the very people. We maintain that side as well. Underground parking system in Kolkata, no place for parking, no shopping place. Why can't we have innovative thinking that in Kolkata's parking should be totally underground? Some of the parts in Calcutta have been successful. It can be done. If you have a plane, you have a plan, you have a team, it can be done. Slum improvement should be done in the world, in my agenda. So that is the one thing that destroys the environment the most. Again, another good news. I just had a word with our mayor just before yesterday. And he said that we have already started taking projects small by small, so that this slum development can take place. Again, there is another history. You know, I started with the history. I started with an IDC lady, Margaret Noble. It's again in my shock of blood that one of her relatives, maybe fourth generation relative, she is visiting Kolkata in the next 2 weeks' time. And the Kolkata's first slum removal project is going to start from the Babajar, where her ancestors started working. This is the Babajar area. I have come there, I have taken the photos of there. The area has been already acquired by our Calcutta Corporation. Now it will take time, I'm sure. A rope cannot be built in a day. It takes time. But the enthusiasm must be there. Everybody must think about it. Unless we get rid of this slum culture, our quality of life will not improve. And this can be in any internet you can find. Pollution. What can we do? Can we do anything about it? Yes, to some extent we can do. Everybody. All the vehicles are doing the most culpable thing. Can we not ban all the devices that are more than 10 years before? Use the relays, use the diesel, which causes more air pollution. Use leaded petrol, no use of leaded petrol. Increase use of CNG gas. In Kolkata, because to get the CNG gas Kolkata line is difficult, it has to come from the coastal area. It is expensive. But unless you think today, you have to think today unless you think today, you would not going to get the result tomorrow. The other thing, it can come from Assam as well, but that is expensive because it has to go to Bangladesh. You have to think about it. What about using other things that cause haze because of pollution? Right. Now, although it is a slope, but in many parts we can use it. Alternative to diesel pollution, we have CNG already talked about it. Solar cars, they are coming. I am not using it, my friends are talking about it. But these are the things we need to think because these kind of air that is coming, the diesel, the petrol, they are just spoiling our lungs. Incidence of lung cancer, incidence of chronic bronchitis and asthma is in a very, very high proportion, even by Indian standard, as compared to Delhi and other parts. Use big buses for less air pollution. Air conditioned buses you can use. Better public transport system. In the UK, we have seen the train services are better and people like use train better because they are air conditioned trains and their air pollution is obviously less. We have to adopt our own policy. We can't follow another country. We have to adopt our own policy. And for that, we have to put it to a sit together and get it done. Why can't we involve the total population? Medicine is not only for the doctors who prescribe medicines. It is a holistic medicine where everybody contributes. Alternative medicines like Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopaths, Yunani, Siddharthi, Homeopathy. They have all their role in this society. They can also play their role in public hygiene, a big role in public hygiene. I'm sure their role should be more pronounced in the future. Sundarbans, as you already mentioned, it is federal, because of pollution, again because of pollution. The random is floating here. The dust here is falling. What can we do? This is a very interesting picture. You might think, what is it? Is it a zoo? No, it is not a zoo. This is a rehabilitation center for tigers. Just 3 months back, our handless chief minister went to Sundarban and found that the tigers, even tigers, they are rolling. Bengal tigers are not rolling, they roll. They are rolling for their own land. They are losing the land. They are in the habitation for this. So they have to come to the villages and they are the victims of the village. So this is a rehabilitation center. There are two names of this bus. She had blind, she had an injury in the eye, and she had an injury in the legs. So they are also trying for habitation, for their own place. So this is also very important for survival as well. If you have a time to go out of Kolkata, do not come. This is open place, you can come, it takes 130 kilometers. The tigers are open, you can go and meet them. They are not caged, they are just stray tigers. They have entered the village for prayer or whatever. We are also losing our other adjectives, other flora and fauna that we are proud of. Bengal at one time was proud of. Whatever you do, it has to be equitable and accessibility. You give treatment to Woodlands Hospital doctors and Apollo Hospital and people in Bostonupra and other slum areas, they don't get. It will not work. Equity is the first word. Equity and accessibility of health service is the first word. If you want to make this world health-free, disease-free, it has to be equitable. And to that end, not only government should work, NGO should work, patient, everyone should work, the doctor should work. Multinational pharmaceutical house, they should come. Because they are fun, they are doing research. I have some that in Ebola, they have already started getting vaccines already. They are working so quick. Prevention of vector control. In 2009, Sir found that vector and just 2 days back I lost a patient with malaria. It happened. Judicial use of medicines so that antibiotic resistance doesn't take place. Use of internet and telephonic consultation. In South Africa, I was just reading New England Journal that day. That in many parts they have controlled AIDS just by telephonic consultation, just by telephone consultation with the doctor. It can be done, it is not expensive. Parameters and doctors should work together. We are not separate things. I am a physician, we are a public health professor. There are maybe other lots of staff here. Those who are microscopists, who are doing something else, who are doing field seekers. They should work together, work hand in hand. They should work hand in hand. And they create an environment so
so that a total healthy care is created. This world is afflicted with fight. This is another problem. It is not in my discussion. But in parts, I'm very sorry, in parts of the world, like Africa, in some parts of Central Asia, people are dying, children are dying because of this affliction. So, Swami, you were told one day that affliction is not our motto. It is a hand in hand, cooperation. Put hand, work together hand in hand and help other people and don't go for confrontation. It was said today, more today, because of this problem that is going, particularly in certain parts of the world that is going, particularly in Central Asia, etc. Just few days back, my son is sitting here, I can see, he's a doctor, young doctor. He was telling me, Dad, I'm going to take a picture. It's a fourth generation picture, Skylab or something like that. I say, well, so what about it? He says, it is a futuristic picture. It takes you in a different planet that you live in a different planet. I was very shocked. But that day what happened? I had a wonderful dream. Wonderful dream that night I had. I found that sun was returning. I find I can again see Kanchenjunga getting better from the mist of Darjeeling. I can see the gashes better. I can see the seas better. I can see the flower better. I can see the river better. Then I realized some magic must have happened. The magic is where? The magic is leadership. The leadership is from who? The leadership is from public health. Everybody come forward and give leadership and give hand together. And give everyone the responsibility. Nobody can be leader everyone. Give banyan, those who can carry banyan. Let them carry banyan. Let them do it, these who. Give the person who can lead, let him give to lead. Those who can give money, tell them to give money to donate. So if you all together stand together, I tell you what Swami Ji says, that we can see a world that is free of all these pollutions. And I'm sure we need not to look for another panel. But today's discussion, Kolkata is on spotlight. And Kolkata's wetland is in the spotlight. I tell you emphatically, is it everyone in this hall, if we do not start thinking tomorrow, even 1 or 2 years time you'll see the land gravel will start building on the other side of the board. That has to be stopped. And we have all stand together. If Dr. Wilson is not there, if one of the then last doctors will stand and will stop. Because planet must be stable, there's no way we can stable. Thank you very much for listening to me.
From September, from July, August to October, November,
we remain always busy with this requirement, yes, every year. And this is one of the reasons what Dr. Maitra was telling, that this all influence, help and trigger the vector-borne diseases. So, all the conscious people, educated people of the society shall have to join and together, so that not only the government, not only the Kolkata Municipal Corporation, not only one municipality can totally change the scenario. If we are to change this, I can give you one example. When we talk, when we advertise so much about the bite of mosquito should be avoided, I know many of the educated people, I do not know how many hands will raise that you use mosquito net. That is the prerequisite I am telling you to prevent this vector disease. We forget to do all these things. This is a very important part. So public health has got immense importance in the Western world. I have seen that they give same importance, emphasis to public health as do they give on the modern medicine or treatment or what Dr. Maitra was telling about the Ayush and other aspects. So, my dear friends, this is the platform, this is the place where we should take some oath so that we can join hands and try our best to improve the public health vis-a-vis the environment, more eco-friendly. How can we do it? Government should help. We should cooperate with the government so that a brighter tomorrow, a brighter society can come. With a few words, I thank Dr. Maitra for his excellent presentation and giving highlighting such a beautiful thing.
Thank you very much. That's your point, but I must say, the where I we think in my opinion the lacking is the lack of communication. In this audience, I on my personal road, I invited housing commission board. He is sitting there. Why I did do that? Because I know the slum removal will not be a Sir Akhtyam or Dr. Subrata Maitra. He can give some idea, you can give some idea. But there should be someone from housing board. There will be someone from Kolkata Corporation because there's a lot of things. So unless you think in a totality, you are not going to achieve anything. So I think that is the idea we think we can. We have to make idea. We have to make team. Pollution people should be brought in. Then you can come with results. Otherwise, everything will end up in this kind of lecture. Somebody will give some gap of gap, mentally, and that's the end of it. Walls will be remain there as it is the actual. That will be. We want to progress.
Perhaps he wants to say something.
Thank you, Shiva, sir, for allowing me to raise a question. Yes, first of all, I like to thank Dr. Maitra for giving a wonderful presentation on the areas which usually we don't cover in our discussion and organization of public health. I was just thinking about, since it's a World Congress on Public Health, can we develop a mechanism to actually measure, identify at the micro level the impact of all these things in the, you know, the segmentation that we have done. For example, the wetland areas, the dried up areas, deep inside the city, hinterlands of the city, you know, by the side of the river, and Sundagon or those areas adjacent to. Can we have a micro level study or can we initiate a micro level study to prove the fact that it's actually affected the public health to an extent which is, you know, very, you know, dangerous, and which has to be taken care of immediately. So then it becomes a, you know, objective, very, very objective and numerical study on the basis of which we can start a micro level remedial measure using the macro concept that you have mentioned. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for a nice question. To answer this question, Dr. Subrata Maitra will not be needed. Dr. Obama will be needed because it's a political answer. Because there's a lot of money, crores of money are there, but you do not know where the money should be spent. Maybe in this World Health Congress, $1,000 of money will be budgeted. But where? Will it be used in African area to reach the poor people? Or would it be used in Africa, Afghanistan to help the Taliban? Will it be used to control the vectors? Would it be used to clean the canals? So land must come from the city. So unless there is a plan, you cannot go ahead. This answer is politics. You need a leadership. A leadership is needed. Proper leadership can take out of it. Just give him a 1,000 crore rupees and do that. And he does whatever he does with that one. Give him another 20 crore to him and he does that. That is not the answer. Plan it. Denote it. Budget it. And give the result. You want result. You want result. That's the answer to this question.
So I don't think any more comment with this thing, this few discussions. I can close this session.
Thank you, sir. So on behalf of all public health office, we have a very small reminder to our honorable speaker, Dr. Subrata Maitra. And also to our chairperson, Dr. Subrata Maitra.
I am very happy to be here, present here. And giving me this opportunity, but I am being sentimental in the sense, because this subject is not only for 100 people. This subject is for at least 5,000 people. This should have been preliminary, should have been done in a bigger hall, where other people should have been participating in the meeting. I'm sorry to say that.